All right, sir. Yes, sir.
To nurture better human beings.
To nurture?
Better human beings.
Better human beings, absolutely. Four corner, yes. Absolutely, thank you. Enlighten the mind. And all of this, you will all agree, leads to one thing. The aim of education is to prepare our students for the real world. Do you agree with that? So when we talk about this, I just reflect back and think about the times. You all know about the Times ranking of universities. You know about the QS ranking. It has intrigued me and I wanted to know why our universities, in spite of doing so well, some of them later on in the industry, and you know now we have some of, we have 5% of the Fortune 500 countries which are led by Indians. Now the question I have is, then why is our tertiary education not ranked amongst the first 100 in any of these? We have sporadic ranking but not regular ranking. And one of the things that emerged, besides the other things like students from different countries, teachers from different countries, the kind of research that is being done, is one of the key aspects that emerged. And the reason why that is not done so well in India is lack of funds. These colleges in the US, in UK, in Australia, Canada, they have a lot of funding and the skilling. So today, when we speak, I want to first begin the presentation. Could we have the flow of the day on the, with the flow of the day, the first question that is there goes to Dr. Joseph Emmanuel. This is the same question for all of them today, in fact, for the first one. If we teach today's students as we taught yesterday's, we rob them of tomorrow, said John to me. Sir, I request you to comment on it.
Thank you, Rubaji. Thank you, GPSC, for inviting us to interact with you on this wonderful day. This is the second or third day I am coming for GPSC's
business conference.
So, I am a regular face and I am part of the GPSC family also, because they are part of CBSC. So after listening to Major Shah, and after listening to you, the question posed before you by Rubaji, so education is for man making. And education, on the way we teach our children, is a reflection of how the children learn. And it must be a reflection of the emerging world to which they are going to face life. So preparing our children to face the challenges of life is very important. And for a 21st century child, they deserve 21st century teaching. So for having a 21st century teaching, the teachers cannot go with the traditional way of teaching. There needs to be highly skilled. They need to develop the skills for teaching 21st century requirements to our children. All sort of skill sets, values, the courage, empathy, sympathy, the way they collaborate with the, deal with the different adverse situations, everything should be part of our curriculum. And everything should be part of our classroom transaction. Our teaching should make them more empathetic, more adventurous, and more entrepreneurial. They should not remain as mere consumers. They should be job creators. They should create more innovations. They should come out with more innovation, new ideas, so that they will develop a better world for the future generation. So continuous improvement should happen through the teaching learning that is happening in the classroom, and we should prepare very strong and adaptive individuals for the society. Today's world is ever changing. It is all the time changing. It's very dynamic, and adaptability to the changing scenario is something unique that needs to be created among our children. So all those skill set and values and attitude and aptitude needs to be created through the modern way of teaching and learning that is happening in the classroom.
Thank you so much, sir. Adaptability is a very, very important thing. I request you to comment on the same.
Oh, I got it. Thank you very much, Ms. Chakravarti. First of all, I want to take this moment to thank and congratulate the Gurugram Progressive Schools Council for putting this program together, but also take a moment to actually pay a tribute to all the teachers and the education community in general, who are in many ways the unsung heroes of the global pandemic. For the last over 2 years, since March 2020, the entire education community, especially led by teachers of schools, ensured that the learning project goes uninterrupted. Although I'm conscious of the fact that UNESCO has estimated that 1.5 billion young kids were removed out of education during pandemic because of lack of technological resources. Nevertheless, what all of you did was truly remarkable, managing professional and personal lives and ensuring that the learning project was interrupted. So a tribute to all of you. Congratulations. There is no doubt about the fact that the entire world of education and learning is going through a dramatic transformation. There are too many studies which has once again demonstrated the fact that if we don't reimagine education, we will be doing injustice to the future generation. In fact, we are in schools especially, and even colleges and universities, teaching students who will potentially be trained for jobs that do not exist now. How about that? What kind of syllabus and curriculum and course structure we will be having for engaging and training people for whom those jobs will emerge in the future? So in that context, some of the more significant questions that we need to ask is that to what extent our current curriculum and course structure prepares our students to be able to embrace that future world. We already knew just before the pandemic that artificial intelligence, robotics and machine learning are going to impact the future of education and the future of work. The World Economic Forum estimated just a few years ago that by 2025, most of the people who are in the workforce, they require retraining and re-education because their skill sets would have become obsolete. Now, of course, we know very recently that the emergence of ChatGPT has challenged once again the entire world of education. Not only our curriculum and course structure has been challenged, but our examination, assessment, grading, evaluation, all what we have always thought was critical to the entire learning project has been challenged by ChatGPT. And I must warn all of us that this is only ChatGPT 1.0, and more innovations are coming in the direction. So the question that we have before us is that, what is it that we can actually teach in our schools, colleges, universities that is not already out there in the public domain for students to access? To what extent we can help them become thoughtful individuals, seek knowledge, but also challenge their thought process, develop critical thinkers, but also develop analytical mind? To what extent we can prepare these young people to embrace a world that is going to be even more complex, and to recognize the need for appreciating plurality and international engagement. All of these will transcend curriculum and course structure. We really need a serious conversation about the future of education, and that starts by challenging the status quo.
Absolutely, so well put. And plurality is a word I take away, because that is, we all talk about it, but are we doing enough for it? Your views, please.
I'm going to request you to repeat the question, because I know the answer. The benefit of what I'm going to say.
Right, so John Dewey rightly said that if we teach today's students as we taught yesterday's, we rob them of tomorrow.
Thank you once again. Thank you, RTGPSD, and every one of you present over here to share and hear our views. Thank you once again. And I want to start by saying that if we were to believe that learning and learning would be happening in the classrooms, we are now sadly missing. But the second is that if we were to continue to treat our students the way we've been used to when we were possibly in school, that's another problem, because again, children are now used to being treated like superstars. And we have been a part of that whole culture. Now, if these same students are not given that kind of a centric orientation towards how we were to bring education as a service for them, to prepare them for the future, all these definitions came from this room right now. You want to prepare them for the future. India is actually going to be providing the youth for tomorrow, for the world. And if we do not change the mindset of the parent-teacher association and the kind of the attitude with which we want to talk down to them, then chances are again we have a different problem. Now if you look at some of these areas, and if you look at the way that they are already being flooded with information from all sorts of sources, whether it be digital, that actually you talked about. We talked about, you know, the academic bodies that are available. We've talked about governance. We've talked about all of these areas. But look at it. Here we are, as a community, trying to mold those young brains to become the future citizens and ambassadors of our country, of our nation.